All right, so we're live, Austin, Texas, anti-Trump rally. We got Mr. Joe Biggs ahead of us here, looking good, looking clean.
Hey, what's up? Second
airplane, I love it. We got Rambo Joe. Rambo Joe's very well-known local celebrity here. Well, I mean, Joe Biggs is a worldwide celebrity. We all know Joe Biggs.
Yeah, so we're not
there. We all know Joe Biggs. We love him. We got a Kekistani flag here and a MAGA hat. So show him that flag, the memers. Screen cap it and post that, guys. I can't post this, you know. I'm on Periscope, so make sure you get them screen caps. Make sure you get the Kekistani flag. Baked Alaska says hi.
10 plagues of ethics now befalling our country.
All right, so let's see how many people we got here.
Much as we do in Passover, to repeat after me the name of the plague after I say it. And if you've got some water or some wine or some apple juice, which is what we have, will you dip in and spill it out with us? Alexander, are you going to help? Okay, here we go. Plague number one, conflicts of interest. Self-dealing. Profiteering from exposure.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Profiteering from the presence.
We got a couple dogs, Australian Shepherds. It's my favorite breed of dog. Australian Shepherd, really great breed of dog. Best dogs. Best dogs you'll ever have. Gotta love the offer.
Lack of transparency.
Emoluments.
Corrosive tone at the top. And tax returns.
Give yourselves a big round of applause.
I'm going to talk just briefly about each of those things because ethics is relatively boring, but I want y'all to hear what's going on and why it's such a disaster in ethics in this country and what's happening from the national level that's affecting everything down to city council and to county sheriffs and to county police all across the country negatively. First, conflicts and I apologize. We'll do some call and response here too. So my kid is almost five, and sometimes he'll say, "You can't do that." So I think that's what we should tell the president. So I'm gonna let you know when it's time to say that, and then we'll tell the president, "You can't do that." Sounds good? All right. Conflicts of interest. You all already know the biggest lender to the president's business empire is Deutsche Bank, a German financial giant that is in current negotiations with the United States Department of Justice. The Department of Justice reports to the president that is a conflict of interest. Can you do that?
You can't do that!
I think that's right. Let's talk about self-dealing. You know, a third of the days that the president has been in office, he has been at his own property at Mar-a-Lago. Free advertising for his property, free money for his property, charging government to stay there. Did he run for president just to enhance his own brand and pay his own properties? Can you do that?
You can't do that!
Profiteering from exposure. Membership went from a discount rate before the election to double, more than $200,000 now. You too can rub shoulders with Steve Mnuchin and Linda McMahon and all of the villains of the current administration if you just pay $200,000. Can you do that?
You can't do that.
I don't want to do it.
No, me either. Who would want to go to Mar-a-Lago? Can't do it.
You know, embassies, among other places, buy nights at hotels. Those embassies now feel like it would be rude to not use a Trump hotel. And the hotel across the street from the White House, whose hotel is that?
Trump's.
You better believe it. That actually is our hotel, and Trump basically is renting it. But guess what? The Kuwaiti embassy moved their holiday party there. Kellyanne Conway got on TV and told everyone to go buy Ivanka's stuff.
Boo!
You know, John F. Kennedy said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country." This president might say, "Ask not what I'm putting in my pocket from your country." Can you do that?
You can't do that!
Failure to divest. You all know this. No one has divested. The president has not divested. His daughters and his sons have not divested. He promised to isolate himself from management of his companies. He failed to keep that simple promise, the same promise that every president in modern memory has complied with. He's drawing money from more than 400 businesses at any time without disclosing it, and his son recently went to Forbes and said he plans to update his father regularly on how their business is doing. Can you do that?
You can't do that!
Divestiture is not... Let's talk about destruction of oversight. Was Ivanka security cleared?
No!
Where are the press conferences? Have we seen a press conference anytime recently?
No!
Is the press still in control of what's going on in our national government? Are they able to give us the news?
No!
Can you do that?
You can't do that!
What about lack of transparency? Do we know what the president owns right now?
No!
Do we know about his entanglements or his entitlements?
No!
Do we even know who's visiting the White House, our house in Washington, D.C.?
No!
Can you do that?
You can't do that!
And all of this from someone who founded Trump University.
Wow.
We expected more. What about emoluments? In the very Constitution of the United States, Article 1, Section 9, it says, anything of significant value from a foreign government cannot be accepted by folks in the executive, right? So Trump, among other things, lists in his 564 line items on his disclosure forms, entities from Qatar, from Dubai. He's selling these entities and he's selling his properties to governments and government officials and accepting money from government officials all across the world. Can you do that?
You can't!
Finally, and most near and dear to my heart, the tone at the top.
Rambo Joe Biggs in the house.
And this is a quote. Rambo, this is not Joe my Biggs. Words. This is an ethics, nationally renowned ethics guru. Donald Trump is making the United States an anti-corruption laughingstock.
We always got people watching.
They say it's almost a bit of a joke to have countries with their own corruption issues come here and laugh at our corrupt government. Can you believe it? Only a few months ago, we were the gold standard and the shining leader for anti-corruption across. Because of this, we can't lead. He's already failing the test. He put a 5-year prohibition on people from the administration becoming lobbyists. Someone left the administration already, and he waived the prohibition.
Russia!
There are 2.7... Can you do that?
No!
There are 2.7 million employees in the executive branch alone. The president is holding himself to a lower standard than his own appointees and employees. Can you do that?
You can't do that.
Senior staffers in the Trump administration skipped the customary and required ethics training when they walked into the White House. Can you do that?
You can't.
Maybe this explains why aides to the president don't seem to understand that they can't sell Trump's businesses from the White House. Can you do that?
Yeah.
Y'all are great. Last, tax returns. Do we need to see those tax returns?
Yeah.
What do we want?
Taxes!
When do we want them?
Now!
Show your taxes!
Show your taxes! Show your taxes! Show your taxes!
What can we do?
Show your taxes!
Don't give up! Become a volunteer deputy registrar if you're not already here. Friends, register your family, register your coworkers, tell everybody about what's going on here, hit social media, and support only politicians who promote ethics and good government. We are the people, this money is ours, this power is ours, and we will make our voice heard. Thank you.
Bill Clinton is a rapist, he raped Juanita Broderick, the media covered it up. Bill Clinton is a rapist, I want everybody to know Bill Clinton is a rapist.
Bill Clinton is a rapist.
Look at you.
I'm being assaulted.
remember, everybody.
Hey, look, I'm being pushed. I'm under assault. I'm under assault.
I'm being assaulted, officer.
I have a free speech right. I was assaulted. As you saw, I was assaulted by the crowd. Look at that. Look at that hatred and anger right there, hatred. An eyewitness. I was just assaulted.
For free speech?
Did you see that? It's all right, officer. I'm cool. We're cool.
Y'all together, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah. We're cool.
No, I want to make sure.
Yeah, make sure these knuckleheads. The guy assaulted me. I was a police officer. A police officer witnessed me be assaulted. So I was assaulted, and you know, I defended myself, so everything's cool.
I just want to make sure
everybody's safe. Yeah, no, I understand, officer. We're done. Yeah, so I was assaulted. Somebody attacked me, and I had to hit him back. So. Somebody assaulted me, and I exercised reasonable self-defense. The police officers did witness that I was assaulted, and I defended myself. I broke no laws.
Then I fucking whacked the guy right in the face.
Yeah, exactly. So, so what happened? I don't want to put words into your mouth. We're live on the scene right now. We have journalist Joe Biggs here. Could you explain what happened, sir?
So I saw you went up on stage, and you did the right thing. You said Bill Clinton is a rapist. We all know that. There's proof of it. And by that point, the whole crowd turned on you, and people started running up on the stage. People started putting their hands on you, putting their hands on me. One guy put a sign in my face. I snapped it in half. And then as we walked down, a guy just kind of sits there, and I saw him do this. And when he did that, he came in, and it was not even like a real hit. He like tried to hit you, but hit the phone and knocked it out of your hand. And then you went back and whacked the shit out of him and cut your hand open. Yeah. And then I went and punched him right there in front of the cops. And the cops were like, hey, man, I don't disagree with what you did. I would have done the same thing. But
we didn't go any further, though. We just reasonable self-defense, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Is the victim of a crime witnessed by Joe Biggs and multiple police officers. I did exercise reasonable self-defense. My hand is cut open a little bit. I imagine that fellow isn't going to be feeling so.
No, he was a bit stunned.
Yeah, I don't think he was expecting that. So I don't know who he thought he was going after.
I guess he thought he had people within his own group that were Nancys that were going to fight back and walked up on two Trump supporters about to beat his fucking ass.
So probably not a good idea. Look, my advice to people is please do not ever get violent with me or physical with me. I only believe in free speech. But if I am attacked and you do take a punch at me, then I will definitely, you know, I will definitely swing back, you know. It really isn't no big deal to me to do this kind of stuff. And of course, as always, we always have to travel
and look
pair.
At this. See how your phone's broken?
Yeah.
Mine's broken from the same stuff covering stuff out here in Austin. It
exactly.
These people get violent as shit, man.
Yeah.
But they claim to be, you know, pro-love and understanding and all this shit. But they're the first ones to throw a fist. They're the first ones to get violent. They're the first ones to spit on you and degrade you and do anything like that.
Right.
They're less than human beings, and they just don't give a shit.
Right, exactly. You want to go grab a coffee?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so the police have told us, essentially, to just leave because, you know, things were escalating. And, you know, that's fine. We respect the police. It was, but they did the...
Knock that motherfucker.
The police, yeah. That was, you know, I don't think he was prepared for that, but you know what? The look on, unfortunately, you know, my periscope, he had punched me, and his punch, you know, missed me, so instead what had happened was, you know, he punched me in my camera, so I defended myself. And, I mean, that's just the way it is. You know, I believe in free speech for everybody. I disavow all political violence. There's blood on my phone, actually.
Oh, that's weird. Tell Trump to release his taxes.
Yeah, so, but anyway, you know, as you saw, you got to see the mob just really, you know, you got to see them just really, you know, become angry.
their mask was off. The viciousness, it was the viciousness, the middle fingers. They were pushing me, shoving me. You know, total violence. And, you know, then they took the shot. You know, then they took a punch at me. And, you know, that's just the way it is, so. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Oh, did you witness what happened back there, sir? Can I put?
Sure, man.
Okay, so could you tell me, sir, what you witnessed at the anti-Trump rally up there?
I witnessed free speech.
Uh-huh.
Hey, we're on Capitol grounds. This is public grounds here.
Right.
You guys were leaving. You said your piece. Some guy came in, tried to cold cock you. Of course, you know, it didn't work.
Yeah, you saw
silly,
that.
Silly, man.
Yeah.
You know, it's supposed to be peaceful, you know, free speech.
Right.
Not violence.
Right. Exactly.
We're not trying to be violent. We're just trying to get our point across.
Right.
You know, show who we support.
Right.
You know, I got people, you know, heard them threatening me behind me like they were going to punch me in the back of the head.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know, go for it.
Right, exactly.
You know, these people are weaklings.
Right.
You know, they try to ambush you.
Right, exactly.
Which is what happens.
Right. And so you watched him, you watched that violent.
I was right behind you.
Okay,
man.
So could you just explain in your own words what you witnessed?
The guy followed you from downstage, waited for you to walk off, turn your head, cold cock you. You know, Joe was right there defending you.
Yeah.
The police were standing right there, actually. They didn't do jack.
Well, I punched the guy right in front of the cop. Like, the cop was right here, and I just went in.
Yeah, you defend yourself. You have the right to defend yourself.
I remember I was walking.
You know, we're trying to be peaceful and just, you know, free speech, man.
Right,
that's
exactly.
It.
So, I remember I was walking.
That's basically what's happening. You all right?
Yeah, I'm good. It's just another day journalism. We're going to grab a coffee. You want to come?
Sure.
Yeah, we're just there. So as you heard from multiple eyewitnesses, eyewitnesses accounts, there was a violent attack attempted on Mike Cernovich at the Austin Capitol building today, whatever the date is. And a fellow, April 15th, violent assault on Mike Cernovich at the Austin, Texas grounds. What had happened is I exercised my free speech right to get on the microphone and say that Bill Clinton is a rapist. And the crowd, they didn't want to hear about Bill Clinton's rape. And then the crowd, you know, they were upset. They were triggered. They began fingering me. Then they got up on the stage. And then they began shoving me. I did not lay my hands on anybody. I kept my hands up. And then a violent, you know, left-wing person took a shot at me. And, you know, he got a little taste. He got a little flavor. I gave him a little sweetener. Just a little. We call this a little bit of Cerno sugar. I just gave him a little sugar. You know, I wasn't unreasonable. You know, I didn't throw the Muay Thai leg kick.
It's like when he run up to a bear and fucking slap him on the nose.
Yeah.
And he's like, what the fuck, man? Yeah. That second hit, he was just like, oh, shit, that was not a good idea.
Yeah, so I gave him a nice little piece of sugar, and then Joe Biggs was right there.
Left
you know,
hooked his ass.
He gave him a little left hook, and, you know, the guy was a little confused. He was a little confused because he doesn't realize you can't.
Well, this is the pro-Trump spot. It's
all right,
pro-Second Amendment.
So yeah, you can't sucker punch us. So I'm gonna go ahead and you know, cut this off. Or thanks again for having me back there, Mr. Rambo Joe Biggs. Hold on, sir. I want to thank you personally for you know watching our back. It's very dangerous out there. And do you have any closing words for the people?
Sometimes freedom of speech gets nasty and people get hurt, but it's all to show how fucked up the other side is. And sometimes you gotta take a beating, sometimes you gotta get hit, sometimes you gotta hit somebody, but at the end of the day, we just showed you how bad these people are, that they're willing to become violent and not even listen to another point of view from a different side.
Right. I would say today was a great day for free speech.
Oh, of course.
Thank you. I'm getting a lot of DMs, Mike. People are lying about you. People are saying that you're threatening the president, which is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Look, guys, I don't care. I don't care. Today, I went to an anti-Trump rally. I took the stage over the microphone in front of all these people, and I said, Bill Clinton is a rapist. People stormed the stage, attacked me, assaulted me. And then I had to defend myself after somebody sucker punched me. So let's just think about this logically. On the one hand, you have people crying about me on Twitter from this living room, On the other hand, I'm doing real field journalism. I take over the stage, microphone check, 1, 2, 1, 2, Bill Clinton is a rapist. Bill Clinton is a rapist. The vitriol, the hatred, the anger directed my way, people stormed the stage,
shoving me. A guy sucker punches me. Gotta defend myself. So you know who to believe. You know who's real. You now know who is real. Who's real? Well, if you're hating on me on Twitter, I want to see you go to a rally that is anti-Trump, get on the stage and call Bill Clinton a rapist. I want to see you get off of Twitter, all these tough guys talking shiznit. I want to see you get off of Twitter, go to an anti-Trump rally and defend Trump. Go to an anti-Trump rally, get on the microphone and say Bill Clinton's a rapist. Are they going to do that? Well, Botox Bill? When's the last time Botox Bill left Twitter? When is the last time Botox Bill went up, marched in the streets, and had anything to say? Botox Bill, all that Botox drained in his brain, guys. Too much Botox will drain the brain. It has paralyzed his brain. Botox Bill doesn't leave the house. Botox Bill wants to talk about me on Twitter. But guys, I'm doing journalism. But here's a question for Botox Bill. Botox Bill, let me see the footage, bro. Get off of Twitter, bro. Go out in the real world, bro. Let's see you go to these anti-Trump rallies, bro. Every city they had anti-Trump rallies, bro. Where are you, with the dermatologist getting Botox, Bill? So before you want to come after me, what's up, champ? Before you want to come after me, let's see that footage, Botox Billy. Well, we won't, because you're too busy on Twitter, shading me, jealous of me. Be jealous. But just pro tip, Bill, leave your living room. Get off of Twitter, go do some real journalism. Rather than talk about me, rather than come after the California kid on Twitter, there are anti-Trump rallies happening everywhere. We'll never see you anywhere, Botox Bill. That is the reality. Attacking me, all you're doing is discrediting yourself. Because people saw live footage, me getting hit. Sucker punched. People see me taken to the streets, defending the message, going after the globalists, going after Bill Clinton, the rapist. People see me take to the street, real life, risking my personal safety. Every day, you're on Twitter. Trending hashtag of the day, Botox Bill. Hashtag of the day, Botox Bill. Does Bill Mitchell take too much Botox and has it paralyzed his brain? Is his brain paralyzed from excessive Botox use? Botox Bill doesn't leave his house. Botox Bill doesn't leave mommy's basement. Botox Bill, is he taking neocon money? A lot of questions people have about Botox Billy. Here's the reality. I'm gonna go have a great lunch, hanging out with my daughter. Ask Botox Bill why he doesn't leave his house and actually go to an anti-Trump rally. Ask Botox Bill how his dermatologist appointment went today. Ask him if his brain is maybe paralyzed from too much Botox. I think it is. Anyway, today, lines have been drawn. Haters on the one side, but you know what? Let them hate. People now can see for themselves. People watched me. Who watched the video, guys? I gotta go eat people. Wait, I'm at the Andrew Torba Gab. Andrew Torba Gab, who went to the anti-Trump rally and stood before violent leftists and said Bill Clinton is a rapist?
This guy right here.
Right Cernovich. Here, right? Mike Cernovich, right?
New media now.
Who's media now, right?
New media now.
Exactly. There, I'm gonna do an interview with him tomorrow, actually. So who watched me go on stage and face down an angry mob? Right? The videos are up. You can go on my Twitter. You can go right now on my Twitter, watch a video of me facing down an angry mob calling Bill Clinton a rapist. You can watch a guy go to sucker punch me. Unfortunately, we don't have a clip of me giving the guy a little sugar. But the head movement, my head movement's on point. Been doing that cardio kickboxing with Shauna. Shauna said, Cerny Pie, that's what she calls me. Shauna goes, Cerny Pie, I don't want you doing journalism anymore. It's too dangerous. But if you're going to do journalism, you got to do cardio kickboxing with me because your head movement is a little weak. She told me my head movement wasn't good enough. So she said, Cerny Pie, we got to do cardio kickboxing. So I've been hitting that bag, you know, been working on that head movement, that headache bag. You know, you got to do it. So the reality is, today said it all. There's an anti-Trump rally in every city. Botox Bill is in his house. Mike Cernovich is out putting it all on the line. Every day I put it on the line for all of you. Thanks for watching. I'm going to go have a great lunch. We now know the truth. Real deal is here. Botox Bill is as fake as the collagen injections in his face. I got some advice for all the jealous haters and losers everywhere. You know, a lot of people who I promoted them heavily, helped them, they never saw their star rise. There are anti-Trump rallies everywhere today. Why are you on Twitter? They're hating on me. Why are you on Twitter hating on me? So my advice to all the jealous haters and losers out there is to go into the field. People want real journalism. People want real news. Do you want real journalism? Say yes if you want real journalism. Do you want people actually going out to the field, covering protests, covering riots, going onto the microphone and saying that Bill Clinton is a rapist? Is that what the people want? Right? So my advice to the jealous haters and the losers would be to worry less about me and hating on me from a keyboard, because people can see through that. People can see through the hatred, right? People know why you're hating on me. There's my hand. My hand's fine. So people can see through the hatred because they watch me in real time, real life, you know, standing up for the movement. I stand up. Who fights hard for the movement like I do? In the field. I go out in the real world. So the haters and the losers and the jealous people out there, I just want you to rise up, raise your standards. For the rest of you, thank you. I've received overwhelming support. It was a very bad calculation. It was a miscalculation, a bigly calculation. Starting a turf war with me is just not a bad look. Hating on me is just not a good look. Because the New York Times hates on me, the Washington Post, CNN, ABC, I don't know, everybody does. So if you are calling yourself pro-Trump, but you're hating on me, you have now aligned yourself with the fake news media, right? So if you are attacking me, you're now aligned with the fake news media. It's just not a good look, guys. It's not a good look. But that's fine. But the rest of you, I just want to be clear about something for the rest of you. I like to troll, you know, tease the haters and the losers, but I do this all for you. So I like to make fun of the haters and the losers. It's funny, you know, it's a good laugh. But that's why I do the journalism. I never lose focus on what matters. You're what matters. The people are what matter. The movement is what matters. And if other people are trying to take over or whatever, you know, let them try. Don't really care. The haters are controlled opposition. They are taking money from the neocons to start war. Yeah, they don't know how to, you know, they're taking that neocon money, that big money. The big money went out. Bad idea. So the idea, guys, is stay love. Love each other. You now know who is about the movement, and you now know who isn't. Very good opportunity. Very, very, very good opportunity. So thank you for allowing me to serve you. Thank you for allowing me to be the number one journalist in the world right now. Thank you for all the support that you give, emotional, you know, some people, you know, financial, just sharing links. It doesn't matter. All support is appreciated, the good vibes. I do this all for you because I love you. The haters can't bring me down. The haters can't bring you down. There's too much love. Yeah, I'm getting a little emotional here. Whew, it's getting a little heavy, so I gotta go. I'm getting a little too emotional. You know, I don't wanna show any weakness on camera, but I love all of you. Thank you for everything. I'm not going anywhere.